very good dish from China.
Yeah. From Guangzhou. Mm. Guangzhou. So they are able to produce it. I think better. Produce it.
So why you are only?
Only
promoting mushroom
and
this, not the tea also.
No, the because of the result looks very good. The ergo mushroom. The effect size is the largest one. So far, from tea, you know, about half, right? Tea have the so-called ceiling effect. It's like a plateau. The more you consume, it become a no more effect. It's not linear. But this one, I can say it's true. You know. Yeah, although a little bit like this. Mm. So that's why also Barry found a lot of, Barry did a lot of research. Barry applied for 25 million last year, almost done, almost get it, you know.
How much was the effect size in the...
Yeah, that's why I need to talk to you. Yeah. So for you, I put 600, but I think from what I read, 600 is should be sufficient for any. If you believe something have an anti-aging effect, if you have 600, if you didn't see anything, it doesn't work. That's my logic behind that. 600 is a good number, but I need to justify it.
So your primary outcome is 1 year or 2 years?
2 years. 2 years, I think we look at the change. That's the, because there are multiple outcomes, right? Biomarker also. About epigenetics, about we just look at absolute change, the mean difference between the two groups. Well, it's a quite a standard design, very standard phase 2B design. I think if you look at the phase, I don't think my, oh, okay. I think I made some mistake here. Yeah, okay, I made some mistake here. So. So I make myself in trouble too much. Okay, so the Chinese tea, gai wang. No, this is another way of making tea. This is so-called gai wang. Gai wang. This is gai wang. And then I wash the tea first. Wash the tea. Then the we don't drink the first the first round. Wash it. Sorry, wash during the second round. And then for 10 seconds should be okay. So I'll serve the tea. Yeah. Yeah. Let me take my I can use the white board. Not here, that's the guy wire. This should be okay now. I'm not good in this. I'm not really good in this, doing this. Okay, at least I made it. Oh, okay, I think I put it into the Gundao
Bay. I think it should be okay, 600 should be.
Yeah, I believe if you say, can you see nothing, then forget about it. How come 2 years?
see nothing. So you will, if there is an effect size of 0.25.
0.25, yeah,
then
should be okay.
500 sample size.
500, I mean in total 500, right?
If the effect size.
Oh, in that case, it's quite.
Yeah, but then you factor for like some dropout.
Dropout.
And,
yeah.
600 is enough.
Okay, so I can write something like we consider a standard effect size 0.25, right? So we need 500, but consider the attrition rate for 2 years and non compliance. If we want to do a protocol analysis, then we need 600. But this will detect this effect size and P less than 0.05 level.
Yeah, 80% is power.
80%.
Yeah, I think if you
we need 80.
How much dropout you are expecting?
10%. 10%.
10%.
Yes. Sure. Can we be more confident? You know, see 90%. Confidence in 90%.
Then maybe you can propose even higher power, 85% in your.
85%. Yeah. Yeah. I want to be more.
Conclusive. So this is not phase 2B. This is like phase 3 trial.
A phase 3, right? It's a phase 3 already.
It is good.
Okay. So we are, if we propose 85% of the power, right?
Now let me just double check.
Yeah, your T. Yeah. You see, that's the why it's very fast, right? If I get you very fast, get it up. Then I spend 10 minutes to write a paragraph, then send to everybody.
I think it will be 80%
power only. 80%. So if let's see, if you see the effect size is 0.25, right?
Yes.
Yeah, and
80%
then
power.
80% power.
5% alpha.
Yeah. 5% alpha.
Yeah. Then the sample size required is
will be.
Five zero two,
right?
And then applying the
502. If we factor in 10% or more than 10%, roughly 10% is 60, right? Yeah,
15% is dropout.
Yeah, dropout, right?
15%.
So yeah, total 600. Okay, that's good.
Required is 590, but we
recruit 590, right?
But recruit 600.
Yeah, okay. Right? Right, so we round up. Yeah, okay, that's good.
Double check.
Yeah, okay, so 0.25 effect size, right? Standard, I can see.
Yeah, so we, anything greater than 0.2 is good.
Yeah, okay.
Yeah, yeah. So I think when we calculate the sample size, we aim for the smallest difference.
So
if it's smaller than 0.2, it's not worth.
Yeah, okay. Right. So, yeah, that's correct.
Don't be so ambitious to assume more than 0.25 or 0.3, right?
So we are talking about minimal
important difference of
0.25. Yeah, okay. Sure. I write it. So now done. Brother. Yeah. So drink your tea. Drink your tea. And then you also get your.
So this is from the previous grant, right? Analysis.
Let's see. This I wrote before. This actually most likely I take from the CSA and also another grant. I still to get it, the chi. Long time ago I wrote one on chi. Didn't get through. So hopefully this time will get through. Maybe you can take a look at anything you want to change. You can directly change.
Okay, so your primary. What is your primary endpoint?
The neuropsychological test score.
So that you have to very clearly specify, because from your objectives, I don't see which one is the primary.
Okay,
so
sure.
You are just listing.
So
some are like operative decline, some are binary, some are score.
So I have a primary, I clearly highlight the primary, right?
The sample size has to be based on the primary, right?
Okay, so it's memory, basically the memory processing speed and executive function. Yeah, so the three domains.